What's going on, guys? Beastly Gamer here. PlayStation 4 update 1.70 has just dropped. That means we can disable the HDCP of the console. Also, we have Share Factory and some other functionality. Here are my impressions of this new update. What's going on, guys? Beastly Gamer here. Welcome to my PlayStation 4. We are on update 1.70. This is the update that everybody's been talking about, and it seems pretty interesting to say the least right now. I want to go through some of the features. I probably won't be able to hit on all of them because I'm getting ready to leave, but as of right now, I'm pretty impressed with what Sony has done here. Now, this update does have some really impressive stuff, and I'm going to go through some of these main features. The number one thing people want to do with this update is disable HDCP, and I want to show you how to do that now. You go to Settings, you go all the way down to System, and in System, you're going to see Enable HDCP. Now, that will initially be checked. Uncheck it, and then you'll be able to run your capture card directly connected to your system, directly connected to your PC. Actually, that's what you're seeing now. This is the PS4 running without HDMI splitter. So it does work pretty well. I gotta say, I'm really impressed with the quality. There's no kind of change, no shift. There's no noticeable difference in the quality. Probably, if anything, it's better. Now let's go on to some of these functionalities. The main functionality of this update is the Share Factory. The Share Factory seems really, really awesome. Let's click on it and check it out, okay? We're gonna go to the sample. Let's see what the sample is, because I haven't started any projects. I'll probably do some and let you guys know how they, show you guys what I make. But as of right now, let's check out this sample and see exactly what it looks like. I did see this sample a second ago. I'm pretty impressed with, the editing software that is portrayed here. I think Sony did do the consumer pretty proper-like. So let's check it out.
Hey guys, I just downloaded Share Factory.
And if it's easy to use, I'm going to use it probably often on here, just for my own footage and then upload it to YouTube. But it does look pretty slick. It doesn't seem like it's anything you can't do in Vegas or something, but for those who don't have, editing software, this is definitely something that would be interesting. If you have a PS4 and you don't have anything, Movie Maker or Vegas. Capturing that footage.
That's so cute.
It's not bad. Yeah, I like the transitions. I like these little effects like that. You can use a game better than Mac. Mac isn't bad. Mac is actually a really fun game. But yeah, so you guys can kind of get an idea of what this Share Factory is all about. Pretty slick. Okay, we're going to back out of here. And, okay, exit out. So I'm not going to save your stuff, girl. I got my own stuff to save. And one of the main things I want to go over with you guys real quick is now you can change the light bar sensitivity or the brightness of it. So we're going to go to, let me see, where would that be at? Devices. Would be here. Alright, so now you go to the Devices tab and you go to Controllers, and down here in the Brightness of DualShock 4 bar, I got it set to dim. Now, for those expecting this thing to really get dark, you're going to be disappointed. It's almost unnoticeable. It's very unnoticeable. You probably won't be able to tell too much difference between bright and dim, so I want to give that a thumbs down. You really can't tell a difference at all in the brightness. To me, the brightness of the controller really isn't an issue. The battery power of the controller always has been. So for those thinking that this is really going to extend the life of your PS4 battery, think again. I don't think that's going to be the case, because it doesn't really dim it enough. Another thing they've added, guys, is called Capture Gallery. And in Capture Gallery, I never saw this before today. You go into Capture Gallery and then you click on any of the games you got videos on. And see, I didn't make these videos, so I have no idea how they were even made. It was just pretty slick. I guess they were on the PSN in some way, shape, or form, and they automatically got transferred over to my system with this application. And you can see the time, how long these videos are. over on the far right. This is 13 minutes, 22 seconds. Okay, so I'm going to fast forward it a little bit and let you guys see, but the quality of this footage looks definitely good enough to be a YouTube video. It doesn't look 1080p quality, but it is so close to being a 1080p type video. And this footage is not me. This is my son, Brett. He wants to be like his dad, so he goes out there and tries to get him. He's a real good Call of Duty player. But at any rate, yeah, the video quality of this application is really good. I have no complaints. I'm actually kind of shocked to see that it runs so well. And so now for the people out there who don't have a capture card, you can actually upload these footages directly to Facebook, and from Facebook you can put it on YouTube. And the way you do that is, you back out of the image, click the share button, and you can upload a video clip. You can name it whatever you want, and you can share it. And now it's on Facebook. So you guys can actually see that footage on Facebook, and from Facebook you can upload it directly to your YouTube. So this thing is pretty damn slick. Also, another feature that they added was the ability to share these via USB or micro USB. If you got a flash drive, you can plug it into your PS4 and you can copy these files and transfer them to other other devices. So that's a really good thing that Sony has done. This update 1.70, I think, has been a great update. So far, I haven't had a chance to really get into the share factory, but from the way it looks pretty intuitive and exciting. I think a lot of people who don't have high tech or very deep technical equipment or software are going to have a field day with the Share Factory and making their own great clips. You guys let me know what you think about update 1.7 in the comments below. I'm the Beastly Gamer, and I'll see you guys next time.